Hello everyone from dark and rainy Kyiv. I'm going the way to the ring road which crosses Kyiv, and it's perfect weather for me, and I decided why not to record one Cardano video. And this video is my submission to Fund3 community challenge. First, I'll need to start, in case some of you don't know about Project Catalyst, but I've been writing about it and I will record more videos about it. But right now we are on the final stage of Fund2. In a week we'll know which proposals got funding, which got funding, which didn't got funding. And at the same time, Fund3 has started. It was announced yesterday on the town hall. If you want to go into details, I highly advise you to watch that town hall. Just rewatch it. Project manager of Catalyst project, Dor, was speaking there, explaining everything. Charles Hoskinson was speaking about the vision of Cardano governance. And you will see the dates, details, but some of the basic information you'll need to know is like 500,000 of worth of ADA, 500,000 of dollars in ADA is the budget for Fund3, and it will be directed towards proposals regarding bringing developers to the ecosystem, dApps creation, decentralized application creation. And also there will be a separate community challenge which is not going to be included into that budget, but which will have a separate budget in Fund5, so like in future, but it will be voted right now, so it will have a budget of $500,000. So the proposal is really, well, it will be submitted most probably in some form, like in written form, like it has to be submitted. If you're going to submit proposal, you need to see the structure, check other proposals. But basically right now I'm thinking about this as a level of idea, and I'm sharing it with you. Because if everyone will say that no, that's a really bad proposal, we won't vote for it, and then there would be like simply no need to make this proposal for community challenge. So the idea is that the proposal will be for myself. I will run as an ambassador of Cardano. Yeah, you might ask, like, why do you need it? Like, we already have like ambassadors from the Cardano Foundation. But this is really, I see, an important step in shaping and changing the governance. Because let's imagine, we have already, and you can make the analogy like with real life politics. No matter in what country you live, I think you can imagine this process. Because like the politician gets elected, and usually members of parliament and members of local councils, they have some budgets apart from their salary. They have some budgets to work and to implement projects, either to be local or global. And it depends, sometimes these budgets are really tiny, really small, and they cover just the operation of the office of this particular member of parliament or elected deputy. Yeah, sometimes it's small, sometimes it's bigger. But that's the idea, that we have a budget and it will be spent in any way. So in any case, 500,000 ADA would be redirected to somebody who is willing to do something useful in the Cardano ecosystem. So like, in a way, you are not giving, like, the people who are voting, they are not giving their money personally, but they are allocating the budget which would be like spent anyway, and in a way their funds which go from the treasury, they will be allocated. So my idea that and I will put a really relatively small budget, which maybe let's say I will check what is the average ambassador payment per month, which is coming from Cardano Foundation, and I will just multiply it by 12, like 12 months, because I think that I'm applying for 1 year. So if I do my job well as ambassador or as deputy, we still can change like the name. It can be called, like, let's say, Cardano deputy, in order not to mix with Cardano Foundation. So I put this amount, and I list my program, basically this program that I plan to create. Let's say, 5 meetups. I will represent Cardano in other crypto conferences. And like last year, it was really not so good year for me. Financial terms, it was really bad. So I traveled only to one conference abroad, and I visited maybe 10 crypto events in Kyiv and Ukraine, 10 or 15. Yeah, but still it's something. Let's say if I'm elected as Cardano deputy, it's like really it's a much more important thing, because the community trusts you, not some bureaucrats in Cardano Foundation who can approve your application, who can deny, who can approve you some ADA bonus, disapprove. This means that you are empowered from the community to represent and speak about Cardano. Yeah, it's like really great. Let's say if you'll need to push Cardano as a perspective platform for CBDC, Central Bank Digital Currency, I would be able to speak with politicians and assure them that, like, I'm not like just somebody from the street, that I'm representative of Cardano community. I was elected for it and I'm paid for it. Likewise, they are paid from the state budget to do their activities. So the same for me, but only like from Cardano treasury. So this is a big role. And another aspect is that it will be a kind of experiment. Yeah, like Dor likes to say on every town hall, welcome to the experiment. It will be experiment because maybe people won't vote for this support proposal. Maybe they will. And if they will, and if they see that the results are good, if like others are going to submit these proposals as well, because let's say for not, I would say like half of 500,000 worth of ADA, like for some portion of this budget, we can cover ambassadors in all of the countries. Yeah, really, all of the countries and regions, especially because maybe not everyone from each country would be like interested running this, because submitting proposal, it takes a lot of time to, some people are really busy and they don't want to apply. But I think like this budget is more than enough to cover the all potential ambassadors who will be ready to go with this experiment. So imagine if that's like a number of people are elected this way, they get funds for this, because they are accountable by the community. They are accountable and they can do, I don't know, like, they are responsible for managing their budget. Of course, we'll hope that they will do it as efficiently as possible. And if these new deputies, if they operate more efficiently and the result from their activities is bigger than from Cardano Foundation, then we can, well, there will be a question. Maybe we don't need Cardano Foundation. Maybe we can really decentralize it and re-elect all the bodies, from the council members to ambassadors, And they, the new council members, they will vote how to allocate the budget. The voting can be can happen also by the project Catalyst too. Why not? So this is the experiment, and this is something which I'm going to apply. And of course, I will continue with my ideas, which I already submitted to Fund2. I mean that in despite the result of the voting, because right now I see that the chance, being a realist, is really small. But I will continue to implement it, because the video channel I can grow with small or limited funds. That's what I'm doing like all the time. Just that if I have, will have a budget, I would be able to do it with a bigger quality, more efficiently, maybe inviting some other collaborators. If no, I will continue it with a smaller scale, and Cardano Hub is also something which can be implemented in some time, because all these small activities, all these like in the raining, these small drops, they get together and then they flow, then they compose a river. So I imagine that maybe in some time I'll meet some crypto enthusiasts who would like to create and join this idea to create a Cardano Hub. Because like different models could be put. If let's say somebody plans a development company to develop smart contracts with Cardano, to help big businesses to implement smart contracts, then they will need an office for this. It can be closed office like most of the crypto offices operate, but it can be a combination with open office and closed office. Then everyone will see that there is like a Cardano Hub. It should be somewhere in the center, of course. And my position is that it should be open as much time as possible. Well, now still it's time of coronavirus, maybe not right now. In future, why not to work, why not to have it open for 24 hours? Because, you know, the time goes fast in the crypto space. Development and communication, they happen all the time. Different time zones, somebody might work with Australia, somebody might work with United States, somebody will work with Europe in this time zone. So it can work, and for me, like, the fact that something which works hours and a small indication of the continuity, that this is something which is like really and speaking with my relatively short experience with CryptoBar and Ethereum, it's really very good for crypto adoption. For example, I had this bar in center, I spoke with members of parliament, with diplomats, I explained them in the basics, because we didn't have like much time. They came either for event or they were just passing by. It's like really effective. And then if the hub works for a long time, a lot of new businesses can be made. So I will continue this idea, I will continue media, and I will apply as Cardano deputy. Of course, my program, the hub and the media is part of program. Of course, I will continue to do meetups, and you know, it will depend, because the year, like it was last year, was not the best year for meetups. This year, maybe I could do, if this will be the same year, few meetups. But if everything is going back to normal, I think it's possible to really multiple meetups, and not only in Kyiv, the capital, also on in other cities all around. Because are some important cities here, like Kharkiv, Odessa, Lviv. There are communities as well. There are a lot of developers. So we'll see about the meetups. I'm learning also the technical part. Well, as for now, I have enough knowledge to explain Cardano to ordinary person. It would be like harder to explain, but even I think like it would be like enough data to enough information to explain Cardano to developers. The basic difference between Cardano and other blockchains. Well, so in conclusion, that's Fund3, and I encourage, like, no matter if you're already a Cardano community member or if you're just like a new person, I encourage you to check Fund3, check Project Catalyst, IdeaScale, register there, and there you can read other ideas, you can submit your ideas as well. And maybe if you think it's a good idea, you can also apply as Cardano deputy. Let's see if people will vote for you or not. And then if we have like several deputies, we can form like really decentralized parliament. So please let me know about this idea and what do you think about it. And you can also say if you would vote, just say your opinion. Because if this idea is not so appreciated in the community, maybe I will abandon it, because there are a lot of ideas all the time. More important is the implementation. So thanks everyone, Happy New Year!